out of 10 cats does countdown. Sean Locke, Sarah Milligan, Rod Gilbert, Rashid Hannity, David O'Dougherty, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
And welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, according to Shakespeare, there are 7 stages of man, and I can name all 7. There's newborn baby, young boy, immature man, immature man, immature man, immature man, dead. To be xanthodontic means to have yellow teeth. I wouldn't know about yellow teeth. Mine are so bright I have to dip them when I drive at night. And a Nebuchadnezzar is the equivalent to 20 bottles of wine, which in turn is equivalent to a quiet night in for Sean. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Yeah. I'm not saying Sean likes to grumble, but his favourite song is Ant and Dec's Let's Get Ready to Grumble. His favourite food is Apple Grumble. His favourite Spring Watch presenter is Kate Grumble. And his favourite ever boxing match was The Grumble in the Jungle. And joining Sean tonight is Roisin Connerty. Roisin is an Irish name meaning delicate flower, and that's fitting, a flower because of her beauty and delicate because she's drunk 2 bottles of wine on an empty stomach. Up against them this evening, it's special guest team captain Sarah Milligan. Sarah doesn't like it when audience members try to video her on stage. I tried to video a stage show recently and the performer got so annoyed she ended up shooting the ping pong ball right at me. And Sarah's teammate, it's Rod Gilbert. Rod was
what?
Brought...
Come on, and do one of your crappy jokes.
That's the spirit.
I'm going to get a ping pong ready.
Rod was brought up in Carmarthen, in Carmarthenshire, in Wales. If you're not sure what that's like, imagine a rubbish bin in a skip on a landfill.
Yeah.
Carmarthen is the oldest town in Wales. Its TK Maxx dates back to medieval times.
One for you collectively and one for him.
Now, Rod, when you've been on Cat Stars Countdown before, you've always got the conundrum. You're brilliant at it. What's your secret?
It's not much of a secret, really, Jimmy, to be honest. You look at the letters and... No, you're right, there's a magic. I've got a very rare disease. I've got a very rare disease, is the truth of it. It's a very sad story, very rare. 1 in a million people get this, where you can see jumbled up letters and then your brain instantly makes sense of it and you can't help it. Like, above your... I can see above your head now floating a B, a double L, E, an N, a D. Just instantly... Brain will just make sense of that. There's no secret there.
Sarah, you're team captain. How are you going to motivate Rod this evening?
Well, I've got some gold stars for when you're good. So if you do well, I've got some gold stars. And I brought some of these, like, motivational things that say top marks and well done and...
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
Made my husband wear them for, like, after sexy time and stuff.
Let's have a look at them.
You seem to have a lot left. Roisin, how would you describe Sean as a leader?
I think he's firm. I think he's a bit of a taskmaster. I think he's fair, you know. He sort of just tells me, like, better be good. He's a good leader. A good leader. I imagine he doesn't like me being on his team because I bring him down, right?
I think he likes you being around because you start a sentence and no one knows, including you, where you're going to. going to go with that sentence. You just go, well, I'll just open my mouth and let's see where it takes us.
And what I don't like about Roisin being on the TV, she's got loads of hair. It really brings out, into stark contrast, my lack of hair. We are like chalk and cheese on the hair front, aren't we?
You could share it, though. Yeah. You could have a bit. Over, do you want a yeah. bit?
No more.
You want to get a hair, just get under it. Like a frolly.
I say that now, but in court, it'll be different. Your hair does look very nice tonight.
Thank you very much. Well, it's compliments to the chefs, the makeup ladies. Right. They've been at it for about 2 hours. I love big hair. What can I say?
And how do you feel that wardrobe ladies have performed?
You absolute monster.
It's an interesting contrast to that. The hair and the outfit don't really okay, match up.
I got here quite late and so I've got a nice stuff. I've got like a dress and a dressy top, but it wasn't ironed because I didn't get it out. And so, I mean, I sort of look like it's a nice jumper. It just it looks a bit like I ran out of budget there. And just carried on.
What was our comment before the show? Was you said from neck up it was.
It looks like I've said, can I have Beyonce hair? And then Sean, it wasn't my comment, Sean said, and said, benefit straight bottom. Like I said, he's firm but yeah. fair.
OK. Sean, if you could have any superpower, what would it be?
I'll tell you what, I'd like to be really good at Countdown. You know, and something mild, something very light, something that I couldn't abuse. I don't want to have to deal with the responsibility of something really serious, like I can, you know, fly, and then that just spoils it for everyone else.
You have to get your phone if you can fly. You can't ignore a phone call.
What do you mean?
You can fly. It's obviously, you know, we're like, oh, someone's falling off a building or whatever. You can't be like, oh, I'm not going to get that. I'm in the middle of the telly.
Yeah. If someone's falling off a building, they don't have time to phone you up. And you look at your contacts and go, right, and where are they?
Unless they're really falling. They can say, go and fly over the Amazon, there's a fire. Go and do some wrecking. It's always going to be a big day, isn't
it? Fly over the Amazon, yeah, there's a fire.
Yeah.
Talk me through your logic there. What's going on?
Right, you sit, you're watching the telly.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Phone goes. Answer your phone.
Hello.
Oh, hello, mate. Sorry, I know you're busy, but there's a fire in the Amazon. And we can't get in there.
Oh, I just want to write this down. Amazon.
Roisin, yes? Do you have a mascot?
Yes, I do, Jimmy. It's this guy, my ideal man.
What is it?
This is a little guy I made at school. I wasn't very good at faces. So I refused to make a face.
You refused?
Yeah. The teacher said, you need to finish that. And I said, it is finished.
did you pretend he would put his head under his jumper like that?
I genuinely just... tried to say not everyone had a head. He was going, there you go.
Sean, just... Sean, all I would say is commit to the bit. I think do the rest of the show like that.
Yeah. You know me, Jimmy? I'm all about commitment.
OK. Rod, have you got a mascot?
Yes. It's sort of because every time I come on here, you take the piss out of me, frankly, about being Welsh and you call us a bunch of inbred sheep shaggers in one way or another. So my mascot tonight is some of my friends and family who I've brought along to show you how offensive and sort of unfair and outdated your views are.
Where are they?
Just in the front there.
Is the one at the end shagging an inflatable sheep?
Yeah, funnily enough, I didn't tell him to do that.
Sean, are you all right in there?
Yeah, fine, yeah.
I bet it's cosy.
It's actually quite smelly. Oh. You don't normally get to sort of live in a tent with your armpits like this.
Yeah, it must be quite weird.
Must be difficult. Anyway, yeah, well, hang on, we're just... Yeah.
Where's my pen?
You guys.
We better get back, otherwise we won't get paid. Jesus.
I'll play Countdown all on my own.
Quite fun. That was very much like being back at school.
I assume someone's doing something behind me.
Are you feeling ghosts? There's no one behind you.
Yeah, there is.
Okay, Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. What I decided, because I've not been doing brilliantly at the show, so what I've decided to do, maybe I could do it for the women. I could try and win today for... Sorry, you're the wrong gender. so I thought that's what my mascot is. So, first of all, what I've got is just every now and again when I need Jane up. Some of the women were joining in, thank you. Also got a burnt bra. It's not really a political thing. It's just sometimes in the summer, my bra smell meaty, so I chucked it on the barbecue. I've also got, that's an angry thrush. To represent some of the stuff that we women have to deal with. that one's been in my pants all day. no wonder it's furious.
That's great. So you're doing it for the ladies?
Doing it for the ladies today.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have, Jimmy. Well, I think we've reached the tipping point and gone over.
Go on, what's your mascot?
I haven't got a mascot, Jimmy, but I'm endeavouring to bring back an art form, to reinvent an art form, which, of course, is the limerick. And a lot of people don't realise that the limerick was originally invented for topical reasons, a bit like the calypso. And I've written the book of gritty limericks dealing with some of the more serious issues that society needs to face up to. This is about the difficult decisions people have to make and which they're only made possible by recent advances in surgery. There was a Kardashian dad... ..for whom being a man made him sad. He went to the doctor, said, chop what you oughta. Honest, it's not just a fad. And this is about how teenage pregnancy in the inner cities, particularly north of the border. There was a young lady from Govan who'd found she'd got a bun in the oven. She was only 14. On sex she was keen, but it's OK, cos the dad was only 11. I'll finish on this one. This next carries a very stark message for which I make no apology. It's about the importance of safe sex. There was a young man from Tring for whom AIDS was a terrible thing. He caught it by chance when he sat on a lance of a sailor just back from Beijing.
Okay. Over in Dictionary Corner, we've got David O'Doherty. David, Susie's obviously brilliant at looking up long words in the dictionary and telling us what we could have had.
Yeah.
What are you bringing to Dictionary Corner?
I'm bringing the dick to Dictionary Corner. No, I mean, I'm here for, obviously, the ratings, the lady ratings. You know, when this appears on Channel 4, people are like, oh. So, you know, doyoying or whatever happens with the ladies. So, I'm also here because, I mean, Susie's the brains of the operation, but she's so nice. I feel I can be sassier than her, especially if people come up with shitty words. I mean, she's never going to go, fuck off. That's what I'm going to bring, a level of sass that this show hasn't seen before.
With David, of course, it's Susie Dent. Oh, I'm not saying Susie Dent is boring, but if you're driving in a car with her, the government recommend you pull over every 30 minutes.
Fuck you, mate!
Susie, are there any words in other languages that we'd benefit from in English?
There's a Chinese word, I think. It's coral. It's either Chinese or Japanese, and it means the fear that your penis is shrinking.
Well, it's a very interesting question, that, because it's always doing one or the other. I've never looked at my penis and it's been the same size twice. It's always surprising me. It's always, I go, sometimes I look at it, I go, oh, blimey. And the other days I go, what is that?
I'm sure, is this your penis you're looking at?
Yeah.
Looking at my penis, I find it endlessly fascinating.
Well, it's not endlessly. Constantly. Not endlessly, that's the wrong word.
Yeah. But it's 46 years old, my penis. 46, it's older than Sydney Opera House, my penis. Freak you out?
Is it as many visitors?
Yeah.
Okay, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. People think Rachel was lucky to get her job, but it wasn't luck. She got the job because she stayed in school, worked hard, and started those rumours about Carol Vorderman. Rachel, obviously you're brilliant at maths, right? We know that. If you could be brilliant at anything else, what would it be?
Well, if I could have another talent, I mean, I'm a big animal lover, so it'd be really cool if you could control birds. It's like there was an annoying person, or maybe like a sex pest you wanted to avoid. You could like get a wall of peacocks, or if they were coming towards you, you could like send the geese after them. Or if they were, you know, really persistent and made loads of jokes and rude comments about you, you could just send a load of pigeons to shit all over their checkered shirt.
We'll move on. OK, tonight the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Violin. He's never had a lesson. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Sean and Roisin, you get the first pick of the letters.
OK, Roisin, you've played this before. You know what to do. Don't mess it up.
Can I have three vowels, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Roisin. U, I and E.
And can I have three consonants?
S, R and T.
And what have I got left?
Three more.
And can I have another vowel, please?
That doesn't bode well for the maths round.
A.
And two more consonants.
And please. Another T and R.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. What have you got, Roisin?
I've got five.
Five. Okay. Five. Sean, how many have you got?
Six.
Rod?
Seven.
Sarah?
Seven.
Okay. Roisin, you're five.
Trust.
Okay, trust. Sean, you're six.
Straight.
Straight. Yeah. Sarah, you're seven.
Restart.
Restart.
Excellent.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, very good.
And you're seven?
Starter.
Rod? Also very good.
Starter. Okay, so that's 7 points for Sarah and Rod. Press it. We're going to smash this. David Rockety, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Susie got a nine-letter word.
Wow.
I would say it in French, a traiteur.
What is traiteur?
Traiteur is a delicatessen in French-speaking countries.
OK, all I would say is, ladies and gentlemen, Susie Dent, Rockety.
How was that made into the... Only in French-speaking countries. How is it made into the English dictionary?
Rod, sorry, what are you grumbling about?
I'm grumbling because how come it's made it into the English dictionary if it's a word that's only in French-speaking countries?
You're Welsh and you're here.
That's true, but the definition of me in the dictionary doesn't say only available in fucking Wales.
Unfortunately.
So at the end of that, Sarah and Rod are in the lead with 7 points.
Of course,
on to our first numbers round. OK, Sarah and Rod, you get to pick the numbers.
Do you want to do the honours, Rod? What do you fancy?
I'd like one big and five small and nothing else will do.
OK, thank you very much. Five smalls are 4, 8, 6, 5, 10, and the big one, 100.
Ooh, it is a big one.
And your target, 444.
OK, well, your time starts now. You know what, 30 seconds is not long enough to enjoy Roisin's face.
Everyone says that.
Did you get it, Roisin?
Maybe, I'm not sure, yes.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
I have, Sarah, I've got it.
Yeah.
Rod?
Yeah, 30 seconds was dragging, to be honest.
Roisin, I'd be very interested to know how you got it.
OK.
Because I believe everyone else.
5 times 100 equals 500.
Yeah.
10 plus 6 equals 16.
Yeah.
Times by 4 is 64. No?
Yeah.
Is it? Is right?
Yeah, it is.
And then take that away.
Oh. 136.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm playing this dip.
You've got a number left.
You're not
done.
And I'll add 8, I reckon.
Everyone was really rooting for you.
you really tricked us there with like pretending you hadn't got it right till the last minute.
Method. Wouldn't have thought of that one.
Thank you. Thank you, Rachel.
Can she have a second?
I don't think that was a compliment. I think Rachel was
she
saying...
She said she wouldn't think it was an interesting method. She did. It was a compliment.
Yeah.
Rachel, out of interest, would you have used all the letters straight away, would you?
They're numbers, aren't they?
Don't you rip that up.
Thank you. That's well done.
I'll put it there. Put it over this guy.
OK. So, Sarah, how did you do it?
I did 100 times 4 is 400.
Yeah.
5 times 10 is 50. Add that and take away the 6.
Yeah, well done.
Thanks, love.
I can't believe I didn't do
10 points to both teams.
And then,
OK, the scores at the moment, Sean and Roisin are on 10, Sarah and Rod are on 17. And here is your teaser. The words are lick this. The clue is it's really sensitive. That's lick this. It's really sensitive. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were lick this. The clue was it's really sensitive. It was, of course, ticklish. So, Sarah and Rod are in the lead. Time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Rod and Roisin. OK, so, Rod, your turn to choose the letters.
5 vowels, 4 consonants, please.
OK. You've got I, A, E, O, and another A.
That's a lot of vowels.
V, F, and N.
OK, and your time starts now. Thank you for that. Rob Hammond.
Well, I've got an embarrassing five.
Roisin.
I've got a four or a five.
Well, if he's got five, there's no point going for your four, is there?
Oh, it might be a six. No, no, still a five, still a five. I was counting the letters wrong. It's a five. It's a five. It's made up. But
yeah, it's definitely not a five.
Are you sure?
Are you going to go for it?
Vaping.
Vaping.
Vaping is.
I can't believe you went for vaping. Susie?
No.
Okay. Rod, what was your five?
Avian.
Well, 5 points to Rod. David, Susie, could they have done any better?
Susie has two brilliant words. One is apnea.
Like sleep apnea.
Yeah, but get the how it's spelt. A-P-N-O-E-A. Yeah, right, dictionary. And the other six, then, is pavan.
Pavan.
Pavan, of
course. Which is a dance.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Roisin have 10 points. Sarah and Rod are right in the lead with 22. Right, now time for Sarah and Sean to go head-to-head. Sean, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'll have one from the top and five from everywhere else, please.
Thanks, Sean. One large, five little ones. And this time, the numbers are 6, 10, 9, 4, 5, and the big one, 25. And the target, 254.
Go again. Go again. I mean, really.
974?
OK, your time starts now. Sarah, did you get it?
I've got 975.
975, pretty close. Sean?
975.
Sarah, how did you do it?
25 times 10 is 250.
Yep.
Times 4 is 1,000.
Yep.
6 plus 4 plus 5 is 15, and take that away from the 1,000.
6 plus 4 plus 5, 15. For 985.
Oh, 985. Oh, God. Okay, bugger.
Sean, how did you do it?
5 times 6 is 30.
Yeah.
Plus 9.
Plus 9, 39.
Times 25.
Times 25, 975. One away.
Well done. Well done. Seven points to Sean there. Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, it wasn't easy though. If you say 9 times 5 is 45,
yeah.
Add 25 for 70.
Yeah.
And then 10 plus 4 is 14. Times them together for 980 and take away the 6.
Oh. You can't say it wasn't easy and then show you've done it. It's like, no, it wasn't easy. It's only because I'm brilliant. Poor old Sarah, thick as shit, didn't get it.
OK, so Sean and Roisin have 17. Sarah and Rod are in the lead with 22.
It's still OK.
Time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. David O'Doherty, what have you got for us?
Thank you, James. What have I got? Well, my name is Florence, and this is my machine. I've discussed on this show before, I have a mildly disproportionate body shape, and so I decided to try and write a song about my struggle. And I realised that was the title of Hitler's book, but this is different. I have quite short legs. They're shorter than you'd think. They start quite low down, and then it's the ground. Pretty tall, but it's all in the torso. It's so hard to get jeans. You don't have to roll up like the trousers of a child. Who'll grow into them, but I won't. This is it. I have quite short legs. If you drew me naked, people would say, done that wrong. You're not supposed to be like that. If anyone had legs that short, they'd be a panda or an Ewok. But I'm not. I'm a man. Just remember this. Long-legged people, short-legged people, we're just people. And we all move through this life together. Just some of us, our legs are moving a lot faster than others. Like a dog beside a horse. Or a dog beside a much, much smaller dog. I was the only one in my class in school who couldn't do the hurdles. My balls would just clang off the wooden bits. You find that funny? I'd like to see your faces on long-haul aircraft travel. Like, oh, I'm dying here, and I'm like, ha, 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 ha. With my tiny, weeny little legs inside the sort of magazine netting in the back of the seat in front, like a kind of a hammock.
David O'Doherty, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are her pants. The clue is they're dangerous to touch. That's her pants. They're dangerous to touch. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer for the teaser. The words were her pants. The clue was they're dangerous to touch. It was, of course, panthers. OK, before we go on, let's change things up a little bit. It's time to give Sarah and Sean an extra player. But these are no ordinary players. They're Countdown super players. Ladies and gentlemen, Susie Dent and Rachel Riley. OK, before you pick, let me tell you a little bit about Susie and Rachel. Susie has appeared in over 3,000 episodes of Countdown, but she's never scored a single point. Rachel could come in very useful during the maths rounds, but if there is a surprise dancing round, you are screwed. OK, Sarah, you get the chance to pick.
It's tricky, because I'm clearly rubbish at both. Do with help from both of you, but I always think I'm slightly better at the maths, so I might have Susie, if I may.
You may.
Thank you.
So, Susie Dent. So, Rachel, you're with Sean.
You hello, Rachel.
So, you've never played this game before. You've been on the show 3,000 times,
a long
never
time.
Played.
No, and I'm really worried.
What are you worried about?
Brain freeze.
I'd be more worried about getting bored. Don't worry about brain freeze.
I think this is the thing. You don't realise until you sit here. That clock and the stress and the pressure and everything, it's quite hard work sitting here.
There's people watching this with proper jobs.
No, there's not. There's never been anyone watch this with a proper fucking job.
OK. Rachel, do you think you'd be better at the letters or the numbers?
Well, hopefully the maths. But there's more pressure on the numbers. But I'm fine with consonants, but vowels, I often just guess. You know, you put the consonants... It's obvious where the consonants go. But some of the vowels sound the same, don't they? English is just, it just makes up.
Rachel, what are you talking about?
It's weird that you were over there and you seemed so intelligent. And you've come over and sat down. It's just nonsense
from
you.
Oh, so it's my fault, is it?
It feels like Roisin's dragging you down to her level.
Sarah, can we get some, like, I feel like the women are being picked on.
Yeah, I think, well, we need a little bit of this. I brought some chocolate, just for the girls, though. Because it's chocolate, excellent. It's Yorkies that apparently aren't... They're not allowed for girls. And I thought, sod that. I'll decide what goes in my mouth. Susie and you guys as well. I've got something else that might help the girls a bit as well. I've brought... It's a new bra that's just come out. I'm sure you like that. So that when men glance, they're reminded where they should be looking.
Into your mind?
Yeah.
Oh, OK.
Which is in my tits.
I think that's where they're supposed to be. I have them on comfort level, but I think they're supposed to be...
Did you just eat a whole Yorkie, Roisin? How much is left of your Yorkie?
No, no.
How much is left? Roisin, how much is left of the Yorkie? Show me how much is left. How much is left of the Yorkie?
I'm a bit grim, mate.
You just ate a whole Yorkie.
We're like a pelican for chocolate.
You just devoured that. You inhaled it.
I was listening to the breath stuff. I was enjoying myself.
You know what I mean? That's Rachel.
No.
Sean, leave it. I think Roisin wants another one.
Oh, I'll chuck it in.
He doesn't care. He's got a wrapper on.
OK, if Susie and Rachel are playing the game, we'll need someone to take over their job. So for one night only, say hello to the new Rachel Riley and Susie Dent. It's David O'Doherty.
So I'm doing everything, so I'm going to be checking as we go.
Check as you go, and yeah. Your dictionary corner as well, so you've...
I got it. What do you want? Some letters of your choice. Is that what you... What do you say? You don't go, what do you want?
Okay. Susie, for the first time ever, it's your turn to choose the letters.
Wow. I will have consonant, please.
W.
Vowel.
Yeah. O.
Consonant.
The letter R.
Consonant, please.
The letter...
Yeah!
Finally, Roisin's seen a word up there. OK. Susie?
Consonant, please.
N.
Vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
O.
Consonant.
X.
I'll finish with a consonant, please.
And an S.
Nice. OK, your time starts now. Susie, how many letters?
Eight, but it's risky.
OK, Rod, what have you got?
Eight, and I'll bet you it's riskier than yours.
It is.
Susie's openly laughed at yours. Sarah?
I've got a confident six.
Confident six. Sean?
Seven.
Roisin?
Five.
And Rachel?
Seven.
OK, Roisin, you're five.
Sword?
Sword, I'll just check. David, is sword a word?
How's she spelling it?
Yes, I've no problem with that. Look.
There you
are. Sword. OK. Sean?
Sex door.
Sex door. Did you define sex door?
I'd rather not. I'd rather your imaginations did that work.
Looking for a sex door, and I'm gonna predict it's not there, but sexagesimal is there. Oh, relating to a reckoning by sixteenths. So, no, that's not, no.
Okay, Sarah, you're six.
Wooden.
Wooden. Rachel, you're seven?
Downers.
Very yep. good.
Very good.
Yeah, no problem with that.
What else we got? What was your risky eight, Rod?
It's very risky. Don't try this at home, but it's drown sex. I've only tried it a couple of times. It's very risky.
Yeah, no. Yeah. I mean, someone, you check it. It's not there. it's definitely not there.
Susie Dent, your first ever time playing Countdown, your risky eight.
I had sex drown.
So your risky eight was sex drown?
Or neo words. There are lots of risky eights in there.
Is neo words a word, David?
Oh, Jesus. I mean, this is the hardest... I mean, can anyone do a turn or anything? I need about neo words. No. Neo-Georgian, neo... I'm sorry, it's not there.
You're not there. Look at your tiny little legs. OK, could they have done any better?
The best that I could have done was whoever did the best one there.
So Rachel gets the points with a seven. The scores at the moment, Sarah, Rod and Susie have 22, Sean, Roisin and Rachel have 24. There's nothing in it. And here is your final teaser. The words are Rod Wank. The clue is it makes your wrist sore. That's Rod Wank. It makes your wrist sore. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were rod wank. The clue was it makes your wrist sore. It was, of course, handwork. OK, time for our final numbers round. Rachel, you're to pick the numbers.
Let's try and do the rising thing. Yes?
What rising thing?
David, have you got the numbers?
Sorry, it's just down there in the cool numbers basement. What do you want?
Too big and four little.
Gonna go with seven.
Oh, no, no,
lower
no.
Than
no,
seven.
No, you can't have it.
It's the wrong
no,
game.
I can't have it. You have to have the big ones on that side or fuck's my brain sake. Doesn't work.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
25. Higher or lower than a 25?
Higher.
Higher. Higher. You're right! Higher or lower than a 75?
Lower. Lower.
Ooh! Higher or lower than a 10?
Lower. Lower.
It's a 7! You're on! You could win something! Higher or lower?
Lower.
You've got it! Last one! What's it gonna be? Higher or lower than a 6?
Higher.
What?
Higher.
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 Yeah. You decide.
Higher.
Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, the number you're searching for is 100.
Hit it again.
Yeah, I've got that. Look, that. That. And some of these. We'll do it again.
Okay, so the target is 816. Go. Poppy. Okay, go on, you better take him. Rachel, did you get it?
Yeah, I got it.
Roisin, what did you get?
I don't know.
It's a mixed ability group, your team, isn't it? Yours? You don't know what you got.
75 plus 25 is 100, times by 900. I've got 900. And then take away some others.
Sure, did you get it?
We had Rachel, so I didn't bother.
Sure, did you get it?
Well, they had Rachel, so I didn't bother. No, I didn't get close.
Okay, Rod, did you get it?
No, I think I got about 813 or something.
Okay, Susie, did you get it?
811, just a bit rubbish.
811, so yeah. five off the base. So, well, I would say, Rachel, how did you do it? But I'm more interested in could it be done, David?
Yeah.
It definitely. Come on, Rachel! Put us out of our bloody misery!
And watch how I keep in between the lines here with my numbers.
Okay, 75 plus 25.
That's 100.
Thank you.
Equals?
Minus 10.
That gives us 90. You're now over 700 away.
Times it by 9.
Oh, that multiplied by that gives us 900. 900, yes?
No, 90 times.
Yeah.
9.
we're running out of space, and Homes Under the Hammer is coming up after the break. So we had a great show. Good. 100 by 90 is 9,000.
Yeah, but I didn't. Just no. 90 times 9.
90 times 9, yeah. 90. Oh, is 888?
810.
910. 810, yeah.
Yep. And then add the 6.
Shit. Yeah, and add the 6, and that gives you 806. And that's how it's done.
OK, so Sarah, Rod and Susie have 22, Sean, Roisin and Rachel have 34 points.
Holy shit!
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now. Rachel?
Is it thrusting?
Let's have a look and see.
Yeah!
Thrusting. So the final scores are Sarah, Rod and Susie have 22 points, but tonight's winners with 44 points are Sean, Roisin and Rachel. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Violin. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Nine o'clock tomorrow night. The Rock, Bruce Willis, Channing Tatum. Film action on steroids. Not saying they are. G.I. Joe retaliation. Next tonight, last leg. Guest of honour, Michael Joseph Pennington Sr. He's got a sexier name. It's Johnny Vegas.